restart this one. Okay, just like that, we install the system first. Okay, before we get this one. So we set up first, we're gonna have attach the spin. Okay, let's say this one as point A. Attach the spin to the ceiling. Okay, and then this gonna be the position of point A. Another case, I maybe not bring this one to you. Okay, for all of our analysis for this subject, we can also explain is massless. Okay, no mass for the spin. So then in this case, when it's not no mass, it's gonna have the same length as before. Sometimes we call it as the free length of the spin. So the spin doesn't extend by its own mass. Just similar to if we put it in the horizontal orientation, no elongation. So what we call this one, I call this one as figure one. This is gonna be as the stretch of the spring. And this horizontal position, I will call this one as the stretch position. Okay, reference the vertical elongation of the spring. Okay, next step. Okay, when we attach the mass to the ceiling, now I attach the first we attach the spin. We attach the spin to the ceiling. Next, I attach the mass to the spin. Okay, mass M. This is gonna be second condition. But after I attach this one, okay, I will wait until it's going into static. Or in this case, it's gonna be static equilibrium. Which means no motion for this one. Okay, and at this point A now, okay, it's go down to this point on this one, gonna be the reference as the equilibrium position. Okay, to reference position, just like this gonna be the fixed line. But the mass can be moved up and down. So that's gonna be continue for the last diagram from this one, the third one. Okay, now we have the spin, have the mass M. Okay, but for this one, gonna be at time greater than zero. Okay, or in this case, we go into the dynamics condition, or this can be at any time when it's moving, and at that one time it's gonna be on this position. Okay, let's say this position, or if I reflect first, I'm going back to this one. From unstretched to equilibrium, that's gonna be the value of delta. Okay, so delta gonna be called as the static deflection. It is a constant. The unit is in the unit of length of meter. Okay, then from unstretched to equilibrium, so it's gonna be constant. Okay, next, if I reference 0 point, go to point A, or actually on the mass length. Okay, I take this one as the y coordinate. So acquired coordinate, gonna be the reference coordinate with respect to unstretched position. Same position. If I take this one from equilibrium, okay, let's say this one has the x coordinate, okay, different point A, the same position on the bottom. Okay, and in this case, become m gonna be the coordinate, and this gonna be right in short as WRT with respect to this one gonna be respect to. Equilibrium position. Okay, so this is going to be our information about the length displacement. And if I write it for you at another this one, delta. So you can see from this diagram that y coordinate gonna be equal to x coordinate and offset on that with the static differential delta. So this gonna be the relation between x and y coordinate. Let's say S1. Now in this case, I will do this one first. Okay, if I take derivative of 1, then I get y dot equal to x dot. Delta is constant, so this becomes 0. The same, take derivative one more time from equation 2, then we get y triple dot equal to x triple dot. Or you can see that velocity and acceleration, okay, they are the same at the two coordinates. So you refer to it as equilibrium, that's going to be the same. Okay, and this is going to be the information that we have about the coordinate. Okay, next. And I say this is going to be first information. Okay, and second thing to do. Okay, now I will consider at static condition, or in this case, figure 2, this one. Okay, if I draw a free body diagram, this depression by delta going downward. So this just like delta going downward. Therefore, the unstretched position. Okay, so it's elongated or extended. So in this case, the first dimension of x sub 1, okay, it's gonna be equal to, I put on this side x sub 1 equal to k. Okay, let's say this is about 4. It is under the gravity. Then, at the body of the mass, we have the energy. And then, for static, then we can use this one summation of force equal to 0 for static, and the direction is can be any direction as you wish. So I take this one atmospheric direction. So I have plus f sub 1 minus mg equal to 0. Okay, I'm continue to this one f sub 1 equal to k delta. Okay, just mg become mg. What I can say is that static reflection cost the spin cost as static k delta time equal to body fast energy. Okay, I'm not going to be in the same case or another way to write it, this one k delta minus mg is 0. This is going to be the concept of the scaling, weight scaling. Actually, the mass, when you buy some food, some meal, something like that, that could be a scaling by calibration. Okay, for this one, then you can know that what the body mass is going to be. Another case, okay, if you would like to know the mass, you would like to know the mass for this one. Okay, I'm opposite to this one for measuring. Okay, you know, put the mass, calculate for the deflection, or measuring the deflection, then you can determine from the mass, knowing the speed and g. That could be some little information that maybe may apply for this one. But I would care from this one. Okay, and we continue for our analysis. Okay, for the next case is at figure 3 for dynamics condition. Okay, I'm doing the same case but frequently in dynamics during the motion. Okay, start with this one. Okay, let's spin the mass. Okay, under the gravity of G. Okay, and then I might put mg first. Okay, and then I will say that the free body diagram. Okay, with respect to y coordinate or at stress position. So in this case, I put this as the reference for y coordinate. And the positive direction of y, okay, that's gonna give you tension in the spin. Okay, and I say this m sub k, m sub k, m sub k. Okay, and then I'm gonna say that m sub k for this one is gonna be k multiplied by y. Okay, let's say this for 7. Next, we can apply for the Newton second law. Okay, by start with summation of force equal to the mass m. We use y coordinate, so this is gonna be y. Positive y direction going down. Okay, that used to have to be the acceleration or the better. Okay, now in the same case, I can draw this boundary and close it. So, this one minus m sub k. Okay, and then plus mj equal to my number. We have NY number dot. I will substitute for F sub K. So this is going to be plus K multiplied by Y. Okay, minus MG equal to 0. Actually, I should write this one. Okay, equal to MG. Okay, but let's say S equation F. One thing, if we go back to the diagram or the problem here, you can see that for this diagram, there are no force acting on this one. So this is going to be, for the case, that we call as the free vibration. Comparing to this one, we have the force. Okay, that's going to be force vibration. Okay, but if no force ever came in soon, that's going to be free vibration. The concept of free vibration, you see that the equation motion, the right side should be zero, no excitation. But for this one, you can see that this is not zero. Or it doesn't show that it belongs to a free vibration system. It looks like something wrong, but nothing wrong with this one. Remind that we use one for this one. Okay, but in our case, I'm not gonna consider it, or we're not gonna be considering this equation as the final equation of motion in our case. And substitute 3 and 1 in it. So we have M Y double dot become X double dot from equation 3 or relation 3 for this one. Okay, plus KY. Y become X plus delta. Okay, and this is equal to mg. Okay. Simplify this one. Then m double dot plus kx equal to, I will switch this one. If you recognize this percent, k delta minus mg or mg minus k delta is going to be zero. Or static. The vector cancel with the body force. Now we have a new equation of motion. Okay, like this one. Okay, and the right side is zero. This indicates for free vibration system. Okay, I'm correct with our question. Okay, then give it to you as a free vibration for this one. Okay, the unit for this also in Newton. And one thing that you can recognize for this one is that this all for the x coordinate, not y coordinate, as in equation A. Okay, this in Y, this in X. And just to remind you, X is the coordinate with respect to equilibrium position. Okay, at any another reference, at space position or somewhere else, okay, you might get MG for this one, but for this case, whenever you use connect, select connect with respect to equilibrium. Okay, you can see that I'm empty, not gonna be in our impression of motion, which means that I'm far. Say not number one. Okay, if I use exponent directly or at the beginning, okay, which means that if I use x coordinate and then when we solve for this system, okay, the free body look like this one. Okay, this is direction for x and then I select for this one. Don't forget that x gonna be coordinate with respect to equilibrium position. Okay, go x in downward. So this gonna be tension. Let's say F. Okay, and then we gonna have F equal to Kf. Notice that in this case, okay, no need to have the vector of mg. Okay, once we use for that with respect to equilibrium, because we know that it's gonna be cancelled. Static spring force and body force, okay, gonna be cancelled. So no mg. Make your own note in this one, no mg for this one. And then this one, summation of force gonna be F double dot. Okay, direction of F. I put in front of the summation sign, this gonna be double dot. So we're gonna have minus F equal to Mg. M double dot. Oh, now we have M double dot. Okay, and this is plus Kn equal to 0. So this is the way we're doing when it is under gravity. Okay, the difference just only by the selection of coordinates using a coordinate with respect to equilibrium and all the energy will be gone for all of the case. Later on you can see that. So this is going to be a very important concept, because that if I make another note, okay, so we need a recommend to use coordinate with respect to equilibrium position. Actually not recommend, just maybe you need to for a better case to understand or writing the equation motion. Okay, this is gonna be the concept for this case. And another one that I might make another note. By using the coordinate with respect to equilibrium position, something like we have this one, okay, and either this gonna be F or this gonna be F, the mass is rigid. So in this case, okay, F coordinate, zero reference can be at any point on the mass. So if we know the length for this one, okay, which means that if I would like to find maybe a C coordinate, okay, I would like to see how high it is, or how high is it below the ceiling. This is going to be equal to x plus L. Okay, you know L, you know x, okay, then L is a constant, then you can know it, how far is it from the ceiling. The same way, if you are interested from the ground, okay, and if I know the equilibrium position, okay, for this case, then the height from the ground, okay, put this one maybe W, so W gonna be for this one. It's minus x in the opposite direction. Okay, so by knowing the equilibrium, then any position different with any location, okay, you know the constant, okay, alpha is in the length of L and the height of h, okay, then you can do the addition to that.